Hi there. So today I had the opportunity to meet with my little cousin, and I say little cousin, she's not a little girl, she's actually a grown woman, but I say little cousin because she is one generation below me. So her dad and me, we're second cousins to each other, and so my dad and then her grandmother were first cousins to each other. So she is my second cousin once removed, and her name is Jessica, and she was a delight today. We met up north at Rock Bottom Brewery, which is a really good place to meet and just kind of chit chat. And you know, actually we've been trying to get together for probably the last month. She lives up in Fort Collins, I live in Lakewood, and we finally did it today, so that made me very, very happy. We've never met before. We share a Facebook connection, and we've talked on the phone, and of course, you know, texted each other. So anyway, today was really, really cool. Got to meet my second cousin once removed, and we went over quite a few things. So I'm going to kind of back up a little bit here and tell you a story about how this all got started. So this is my dad, Denver Lee, and this is my stepmom, Sarah. Denver, my dad, died in 2004, December 15th, 2004. About 8 months before he died, I went to Dallas to visit him, and he gave me a box, just a cardboard box of files that he had been researching on the Riley line. And so, you know, we talked about that, and, you know, I'd always been kind of interested in that, but never really anything seriously. And so, that was actually the last time I saw my dad alive. He gave me that box, and I brought it back to Colorado, and I didn't open it. I didn't open it for 7 or 8 years, and it just sat in my closet. And finally, one day, I was cleaning out some things, and I came across that box. I'd actually forgotten about it, and started going through it. And in that box, there were lots of files. He had done such a tremendous amount of research on the Riley line and some of our, you know, other grandfathers and grandmothers and things like that. Just very fascinating. So I pulled it out and started looking through it, and then you know, I did that for like about a month or two, and then I decided I was going to get on Ancestry.com. I got on Ancestry.com. I think that was in February 2011, so 2.5 years ago, and just started putting in the information that was in that box. And I started doing my family line, and then on Ancestry, I don't know if you're familiar with it or not, but you can see other people who are researching the same thing. And so the same line, the same people, because it keeps coming up, you know, that they're doing the same thing that you are doing. And my Jessica, my cousin, she also had a family tree, and I found that she was researching the same things that I was. And so I dug a little deeper, and I thought, well, we're related. So I didn't really know how we're related, but I knew that we were related because of all the information that I had on Ancestry. And then I thought, and she had a picture of herself on Ancestry, which you can do like as part of a profile picture. And I thought, well, she looks young enough. I wonder if she has a Facebook page. So a couple of months ago, I sent her a message via Facebook, and I didn't hear back. And then finally, I don't know, 6 weeks ago, 8 weeks ago, she sent a message back, and for whatever reason, because I wasn't her friend on Facebook, it went into the other box, kind of like the spam box is what she said. And she replied, and she goes, yes, if that's true, who your line is and my line is, then we are related. And so then we called each other, and we talked probably for an hour, and we're just simply amazed at some of the similarities that we have between us. And anyway, she's What a beautiful young woman she is, and she's just flippin' smart, very creative, has lived here in Colorado for like the last 10 years, and she gardens, and she loves her dogs, and anyway, she's just a fantastic She's a fantastic little cousin. So, so today, I, in that same box, actually, that my dad had given me, there was this. And this is a book that one of his cousins had put together, and it's about the Riley line. And on this cover, it is my great-grandfather, Squire Riley, and his wife, Elizabeth Sandlin, and part of their children. Squire was married prior to that to America Smith. They had five children, and then apparently America died. And then he married Elizabeth Sandlin when she was only 16. So she went into a family with five children that she started raising. And then guess what? She had 19 more. 19 children. And here are some of them. And this is actually a picture in Doorway, Kentucky. I think it's around 1911, something like that, with part of Squire's children from his first marriage, America Smith, and then all these other ones are from his second wife, Elizabeth Sandlin. So I started showing Jessica all the things in this book, and there's a whole bunch of pictures, and then just lineages, and I mean just a wealth of information, and she was so fascinated by it all. All she had to go by was a couple of pieces of paper that her grandmother had written out some of these names, like Jesse Bolling, Mary Pennington, Sarah Pennington, the Johnstons, the Bargers, some of those other relatives that were, you know, back in the 1800s in along the Middle Fork of the Kentucky River. So anyway, we spent a good 3 hours at Rock Bottom Brewery just kind of going over some of this stuff and going through pictures, and we found her family in here, and I showed her my family. So anyway, it was just a really, really cool experience, and you know, of course, now we're friends, and we're more than just cousins. So we just hit it off, and she's gonna be a good friend for a really long time, hopefully for the rest of my life. Anyway, just a really cool girl. So anyway, it was just a good day, and just a wonderful experience just connecting with family. And I'm going to try to talk her into going to Kentucky with Laura and I one of these days. I don't know if she'd be into that or not, but hopefully she would. It'd be kind of fun, and just kind of show her around, because she doesn't really know like the exact area where the Rileys started, with Patrick Riley Sr., Patrick Riley Jr., Gentleman John, Samuel, Henry, Riley, Squire Riley, Walter Riley, Denver Riley, and then me. So anyway, just a cool day, and really, really looking forward to getting to know her more, and maybe her family as well too, because I've never met any of those people. So anyway, just really cool, and so that's it. One thing that I forgot to mention about that, all that research that my dad did, this was, like I said, like prior to 2004, before he died. And so what has changed since then is that some of that information, especially the Rileys back in Russell County, Virginia, back in the late 1700s, and there's a book that was written by Michael Ports, and he, these four Riley gentlemen, I think it was Daniel Riley, Patrick Riley Sr., Nathaniel, and John. I think that was the four brothers, or what they thought were four brothers. Well, come to find out, one of those guys, Daniel Riley, is not one of the brothers. And you know how we found that out? Through DNA. DNA is the key. For all these years, and I can't tell you how many genealogists have associated these four men as being relatives, and have even written some books on them, as like that's a fact, it comes to come to find out it's not a fact. I was in contact with an Anthony Riley, who I found on like one of the gen forums, and I emailed him, and I asked him, I said, have you ever done a DNA test? And he said, no, I thought about it a couple of times, but I've never done it. And I said, well, my little brother Patrick has done a test, and so have some of the other Riley men in this line have done some tests, and so we all know that we're related through DNA. And I said, it would be really cool if you could do a DNA test. They're only like $59. Do a DNA test on like my family tree DNA, you know, and let's just prove it once and for all. Let's just say, you know, we're related, because everybody thinks that we're related. And so this was prior to the August family reunion, and the results weren't back yet, but he did get the results about 3 weeks ago. Guess what? We're not related. Completely, completely different haplotype. And so, we're not even from the same family line. I mean, nothing. So he was shocked. I was shocked. And I'm sure Michael Ports would probably be shocked as well. He's the one who wrote the book on those four men in Russell County, Virginia, back in the 1700s. And I mean, it has some good information in there, but you just can't ever assume that you're related, because DNA proves it once and for all. It's like black and white. You either are or you're not. And he was not. But what it did do for Anthony Riley, he now knows where to go looking for his relatives. And so he did find some of them, and I think they had moved to Illinois back in the 1800s. And so now he is researching the Wright family tree. And now for the Rileys in Kentucky and the Rileys that were in early Virginia at that time, we now know that, you know, they weren't related. So we need to quit associating Daniel Riley with Patrick Riley Sr. and the other two brothers, because they're just not related. So next, the important thing would be to get the other two brothers, their line, some of the male Rileys down their line, because it only works with the males, with the Y DNA. And so get those guys to do a DNA, and then we can prove once and for all whether they were brothers and if they're even related. So DNA is so fascinating, but it is the final verdict of whether you're related or not, and it's changing the way people do research. It's changing the way people look at family groups, and all of that. So it's just really fascinating. But it was an eye opener, and like I said, Anthony was shocked, and so was I. So I would like to get a hold of Michael Ports and kind of let him know, so he doesn't write about it anymore and confuse people. Another part of the DNA is has to do with the bowlings. So there's three different kinds of bowlings, and it's called red, white, and blue. The red bowlings were related to Pocahontas, and a lot of people in Kentucky think that they're related to Pocahontas through the bowlings, and DNA has proved that wrong as well. And so there's another set of bowlings called the white bowlings, because Robert Bowling, after his first wife died, she was the granddaughter of Pocahontas, and they had one child, John, I believe, Colonel John Bowling. And everybody who's related to Pocahontas comes from that line. Pocahontas' granddaughter died, I think, in childbirth, and then so Robert Bowling married Anne Stith, is her name, S-T-I-T-H-E. And all those children from that marriage are called the White Bowlings, and I'm related to the White Bowlings. I'm also related to the Blue Bowlings. The Blue Bowlings are has to do with Benjamin Bowling and Jesse Bowling. And for some reason, the genealogist back, you know, even over 100 years ago, associated Benjamin Bowling and Jesse Bowling with Pocahontas' descendants. And that's just not true. DNA has proved it once and for all that those are a different set, that's a different family. So there's three Bowlings. The red Bowlings, related to Pocahontas and her descendants. The white Bowlings, related to Robert Bowling and Anne Stith. And then the blue Bowlings, because they came out of the blue. Nobody can account for like where they came from. So it's just kind of fascinating that DNA has blown this wide open. And you know, on Ancestry.com, I still find people who think that they're related, and I look at their family tree and I'm like, you are not related. You are not related to Pocahontas. So it's just kind of funny, because people really want that. They want to be related to Pocahontas. But what I can say about me and my family is that Pocahontas was my 10th great-step-grandmother. Not a lot of people can say that, and so that kind of makes me proud. And I told that to Jessica today as well. So, but she had heard that she was related to Pocahontas too, and I had to kind of tell her, well, No, you're not. But it's cool that she was your step-great-grandmother, your 10th step-great-grandmother. So, anyway, it was just kind of cool, and what a day. I'm tired. I think I need to go to bed now.